मेरे चिल्ड्रन, अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू यू ऑल। हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू आर फाइन एंड यू आर सेफ। मेरे चिल्ड्रन, हैव यू ऑल कॉपी द आंसर्स इन योर साइंस नोटबुक? यस, ओनली वन और टू स्टूडेंट्स हैव सेंड देयर स्नैपशॉट्स टू मी। व्हाट अबाउट द अदर्स? आई नीड टू चेक माई डियर चिल्ड्रन वेदर यू हैव रिटन करेक्टली और नॉट। ओके ओके माई डियर चिल्ड्रन, बिफोर एंटरिंग इन टू द टूडेज क्लास, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी आर गोइंग टू रीड एंड लर्न द क्वेश्चन आंसर इन चैप्टर 5। ओके, सो जस्ट टेक योर साइंस नोटबुक एंड टेक ए पेंसिल विथ यू, रीड अलॉन्ग विथ मी। ओके 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 माई डियर चिल्ड्रन, वी विल स्टार्ट। ओके, टेक योर साइंस नोटबुक and take a pencil with you and read along with me. Okay, so what's the first question? What are flesh eating animals called? Say, what are flesh eating animals called? Flesh eating animals are called carnivores. Flesh eating animals are called carnivores. Okay, then second question, why do carnivorous animals have sharp and pointed front teeth? Okay, why do carnivorous animals have sharp and pointed front teeth? Carnivorous animals have sharp and pointed front teeth because it helps them to catch their prey and tear into its flesh. Okay, so why carnivorous animals have pointed front teeth? Because the teeth will help them to catch the prey. Okay, the teeth will help them to catch the prey and tear it into their flesh. Okay, and tear their flesh. Okay, tear and help them to tear their flesh. Okay, then next, how do frogs catch their prey? Okay, how do frogs catch their prey? Frogs catch their prey by rolling out their long sticky tongue quickly. How frogs catch their prey? By rolling out their long sticky tongue. Okay, long sticky tongue. Frogs catch their prey by rolling out their long sticky tongue quickly. Very quickly, they roll out their long sticky tongue. Okay, why do omnivores eat? What do omnivores eat? Omnivores eat both plants and meat. Omnivores eat both plant and meats. Okay, then next one, name a bird with sharp hooked beak. You can even write vultures. Okay, vultures also you can write. Yeah, which vultures or eagles have a sharp hooked beak? Vultures or eagles have a sharp hooked beak. Okay, as your wish, you can either write vulture or eagle. Okay, then next one, answer the following questions. Okay, answer the following question. What are herbivorous? Name three herbivorous animals. What are herbivorous? And name three herbivorous animals. Herbivorous are animals that eat only plants. You all know that herbivorous animals eat only plant. They eat the leaves, flowers, fruits, nuts, or even the bark of trees. Okay, my dear children, don't forget to put the full stop between the sentences. Okay, this is the mistake you all have done in your exam papers. Okay, so herbivorous are animals that eat only plants. So there's a full stop. They eat the leaves, flowers, flowers, fruits, nuts, or even the bark of trees. Full stop. Then sheep, cow, and deer are examples of herbivorous. Finally, a full stop. Okay, herbivores are animals that eat only plant. They eat the leaves, flowers, fruits, nuts, or even the bark of trees. Sheep, cow, and deer are examples of herbivores. Okay. Okay, my dear children. Then we will move on to the next lesson. Okay, our next chapter, chapter 6. Okay, so far we have completed up to 5 chapters. Today we are going to learn a new chapter. So what is the topic of the lesson? Movements of animals. Movements of animal. You are moving from one place to another, right? So that movement, how the animal moves from one place to another. In this chapter, we are going to learn about that. Okay? So, the most important feature of human being is movement. Okay? We have the ability to move from one place to another, which is the most important feature. Okay? Which is the most important feature of a living being. In our previous lessons, we have learned about how they prepare their food. And they need to move from one place to another in search of food and for their shelter, right? So, in this chapter, we are going to learn about the movements. Okay? Animals, we people, human beings, we move from in the ground, above the ground, under the ground also we are moving, right? Animals can fly in the air, can swim in the water, they move on the surface of the ground, and the under the ground also they are moving. So there are different ways of movement in every animals. Okay, there are different ways of movement in each animal. So, in this lesson, we are going to learn about the different types of movements. How the animals, human beings are moving from one place to another. Okay. First of all, we are going to learn about the movement of animals. How the animals are moving. Okay. First, most animals such as deer, lion, tiger, hippopotamus and so on walk on with four legs. Okay. So far, first one, deer. Lion, dog, hippopotamus, okay? They walk with their four legs. We all know that dog have four legs. So, they walk with their four legs, okay? Then, camels have long legs with strong and powerful muscles. So, they can walk long distance without getting tired. Okay, we all know that camels live in the desert region. So, camels want to move for a long distance in the sunlight. So, the body of the camel is very sturdy. Okay, they have powerful muscle and their legs are so strong. Okay, this ability will help them to walk for a long distance without getting tired. If you walk for a kilometer, half a kilometer, if you walk for a long time, we will get tired, right? So, without getting tired, the camel can have the ability to walk for a long distance. Okay? Then, camels have broad padded feet which helps them to walk on the sand without sinking into it. The leg of the camel is very long and it is very strong and the feet is very like a padded. It is very thick, okay? It is very thick. It is called as padded feet, okay? So, what's the purpose of this padded feet? So, the sand in the desert have the ability to sting inside. If you walk on the sand, we will get sting inside the sand. So, the padded feet help the camel to walk on the sand without sinking. Okay, do you understand? Okay, this padded feet help the camel to walk on the sand without sinking. Okay, then next one, some animals such as cheetah. Do you know cheetah? So, this is cheetah. Okay, this is cheetah. Can run very fast. Okay, cheetah have the ability to run very fast. They have long and strong legs that help them to run fast. So, the cheetah can run fast, right? So, the legs are very long and very strong. Okay, this helps them to run very fast. So, what are the animals we have learned? First of all, deer, lion, dog, hippopotamus will walk with their four legs. The next one we learned about camels, right? So, the leg of the camel is very strong and the muscles are very powerful so that they can walk for a long distance without getting tired. Then, what type of feet does camel have? Camel have padded feet. What's the use of this padded feet? Which helps them to walk on the sand without sinking in. The next animal is cheetah. Cheetah have the
ability to run very fast. So what, how they can run very fast? Because their legs are very long and very strong. Okay, the next one. Some animals such as tortoise and snail walk very slowly. We all know that tortoise and snail. Tortoise, what do you mean by tortoise? Tortoise lives in water, right? So tortoise will move very slowly. Meanwhile, snail also walk very slowly. Okay, monkey leap from tree to tree. Okay, monkey, here this is monkey will leap. They jump from one tree to another tree. Okay, that is leap. Okay, monkey leap from tree to tree. They have long limbs that help them to leap and their tails help them to maintain balance. See, their limbs. Okay, their limbs are very long. Okay, their limbs are very long and their tail is also very long. So, this limbs helps them to move from one tree to tree and this tail will help them to maintain the balance without getting falling down. Okay, maintain balance to move from one tree to another. Okay, then animals such as rabbit and kangaroo hope to move from one place to another. Jump. So what do you mean by hope? Jump. Okay, they jump from one place to another. Rabbit also jump from one place to another, and then likewise kangaroo also move from one place to another by hopping. Hopping means they jump. Okay, kangaroos have strong hind limbs. Okay, kangaroo have strong hind limbs. Okay, then they have thick tail that help them. See, like the monkey, it also have a long and thick tail which helps them to maintain the balance. Okay, I'm repeating again. First, tortoise and snail walk very slowly. Then monkey leap from one tree to another and the limbs helps them to leap from one place to another and then tail helps them to maintain balance. Likewise, rabbit and kangaroo jump from one place. Which word we use instead of jumping? Hope. Okay, hope from one place to another, and the kangaroo also have the limbs and their tail helps them to maintain balance. Okay, the next one. Spiders, caterpillars and millipedes have many legs that help them to crawl. See, millipedes have many legs. Likewise, spiders also have many legs. Then millipedes also have many legs. So, the movement is crawling. Okay, crawling. Okay. Insects such as ants crawl on their six legs. So, how many legs the ant have? Six legs. Okay, ant have six legs. And they crawl. Some insects such as honeybees and mosquitoes have wings which helps them to fly. Okay, honeybee, mosquito, butterfly have wings which helps them to fly. Okay, then animals such as snakes, slither and earthworm wriggle on the ground. Okay, slither means they move from one place to another. Wriggle means they twist their body. Okay, they twist their body for movement. Okay, they twist their body for movement. Snake means there is a smooth, they move smoothly, but the earthworms twist like a twist. They move the part of the body and twist it to move from one place to another. Okay, then snake have no legs. So snakes have the special scales in the body. Special scale, the upper part of the skin. Fish have scales, right? We remove the scales before eating, right? So that scale, snake also have a type of the scale which helps them to move in the sand. Okay, so repeating again, first spider and caterpillars, they have a large number of legs so they can crawl in the ground. Then insect will fly with the help of their wings. Last one, snake, they crawl in the, they slither in the sand. Meanwhile, earthworm will wriggle on the ground. Okay, the next one. Fish swim in water using their fins. We all know that with the help of their wing fins, the fish will swim in the water. Their tail and fin help them to see. The tail fin. the tail fin help them to change the direction. Okay, help them to change the direction in the water. Okay, then some animals such as sea turtles, penguins, crocodiles can walk and swim in water. Penguins have the ability to walk. Likewise, sea turtle, penguin, crocodiles also have the ability to walk, and they can have the ability to swim in the water. Their flippers helps them to walk and swim. See, this is the flipper. In the seal also there is a flipper. Can you able to see that? This is the flipper. Okay, so this helps them to walk and swim. Seals are slow on land but are fast swimmers in water. This is the seal. Okay, this is the seal which is very slow in the water, which is very slow in the land for walking, but it is a very fast swimmer in the water. Okay, do you understand? So this is enough today. We will meet in our next class. Okay, so my dear children, learn the chapter 5, start to learn. Okay, if you have any doubt you can call me or text me before 5 o'clock. Okay, my dear children, bye.